Good morning, students. As we have started our new lesson sound, in that you have studied the definition of sound, you have studied the production of sound also, and today you are going to study the propagation of sound, how the sound propagates or how the sound travels, that you are going to study in today's video. Now you can see that sound is a wave motion. Okay, types of motions you have studied, but here as you have studied periodic motion means the motion which acts periodically, okay, with equal interval of time in as every points. Okay, so here sound is also wave motion. Means what? You are going to study first the wave. What is wave? We will study. Okay, so all this concept you are going to study. Before going to this concept, generally I am going to explain how the sound travels from a point to the listener's ear. Okay, this first I will explain you in general. Now here I will explain you. Now an example I will give you, as yesterday video also I have given you, that if a bell is ringing, okay, how the sound of the bell propagates from that place to our ears. Okay, so suppose this is the bell, here I will drop, okay, and here what happens, the bell rings, okay, it produces sound. And this sound, how it travels from one place and reaches to our ear. Okay, this propagation you are going to study now, how the sound will propagate. So at this condition, what happens? That when the bell is ringing, means what? This gong hits this metal outer part. Okay, when it hits, what happened? There is a vibration, production of vibration, or here the vibrations are produced, and this vibrations are passed in the air medium. As you know, in this everywhere there is air medium, air particles are present. Okay, so what happens when this vibrations are produced in this bell? It passes the vibration to nearby air molecules. Suppose here air molecules are present, these are the air molecules present in the part. Okay, these are the air molecules which are present in our surrounding, our nearby us. So what happens, these vibrations are passed through the air particles. Now here, suppose here more air molecules are there, so what happens, here air density is more, so what happens, there is a more colliding air molecules to each other, they vibrates. Now see, suppose this is one molecule, so when the vibration from this bell passes through this air molecule, what happens at its main position, at its place, what happens, it vibrates, the air molecule vibrates. Okay, while vibrating, it hits nearby molecule. Okay, so another second particle, it vibrates again. Okay, then while vibrating, the second particle hits third air particle or air molecule. So like this, what happens, each air molecules get vibrates, and it vibrates to the nearby air molecules. This way, what happens, the sound travels until it reaches to our ear. This way, what happens, the vibrations is produced in the air molecules, air molecule vibrate. While vibrating, what happens, suppose this is an air molecule, this is vibrating, while vibrating, what happens, it hits the nearby air molecule, means it gives its energy to another air molecule to vibrate, then the second one will vibrate. Okay, while vibrating, it will hit nearby molecules. Like this hitting, what happens, it passes like this, it transfers its vibrations, and till when it transfers until the vibrations reaches to our ear. When it reaches to our ear, then also the vibration, there is a passing of this vibration, and this vibrations reaches our ear's diaphragm. When it reaches to our ear's diaphragm, that time what happened, our diaphragm also vibrates, and when our diaphragm of ear vibrates, that time this signal is sent to the brain, and there the brain recognizes the sound. Okay, this is how the propagation of sound takes place. Now in the propagation of sound, this is a simple way I have explained you how the sound travels through the air medium. Okay, now here while going, here Now, as you know, the density, density means what? If more air molecules are present, you will see, say that the density is high. If low air molecules are present, then you will say the density is low density. Okay, so this is the density part. Now, I want to tell you about the density. This was a simple explanation I have given that how the air particle vibrates. Now, one air molecule I have shown you. Now, we are going to consider density of air molecules. What happens if there is, now this was for one molecule. Now, I will show if many are there, okay? At this near the bell, there are many particles, many air molecules are there. Near that. So, what happens, all these together, when this hit, when the bell rings, that time what happens here, more are there. So, now I will show it in a line pattern. See here, more density is there. So, what happens, I have shown more lines. Okay, means more are vibrating, more air molecules are vibrating over there. Okay, and what happens here also, air molecules, so it comes near and here. This pattern it follows. I will show you, I will first draw and I will explain you. Okay, this is the propagation of sound. Means here you can see the air molecules while vibrating means what? Once it comes together and it makes a high density part. Okay. And when it goes away, what happened? Again, low density. Then again, when it comes together, all molecules, again high density. When it goes again far away, again low density. So this you can see while vibrating, while passing the vibrations, you can see at one point it creates a high density air medium. Then nearby it will produce, when all the molecules will come this side, closer, what happens here? Low density pattern occurs. Okay, so what happens again? These are vibrating. It is, so this vibration is passed to the next part. So at this part, what happened? Again high density, again nearby low density, again high density, like this it is passing. So this part you can see, it is high density part, this low density part, this again high density, this again low density, high density, low density. This way it reaches to our eye. High, low, this way it, what happens? It vibrates and this vibration reaches to our ear. Now, specific names is given for this high density and low density part. Okay, where the high density is there, it is, that part is called as compressions. Okay, and the low density part is called as rarefactions. Rarefactions. See here, high density part is called as compression. And this part is called as rarefactions. Okay, now see, compression means their air molecules get compressed, that's why that part is called as compression. And rarefaction means that there is low density part. Okay, so this low density part is called as rarefaction. Okay, so this is how the sound propagates. Now in this topic you are going to study some terms. Okay, some important terms you will study related to this. Now, I want to convert this pattern into a graphical pattern. Okay, so how we will convert that, I will explain you. And before going to that, we will first study what is wave motion, this part we will study. As your sentences are written, sound is a wave motion. Sound is traveling, but how it is traveling? It is traveling in a wave motion. One more thing I want to tell you, that you have studied that light travels in a straight line. Light always travel in a straight line, but sound travels, how the sound travels? Sound travels in a wave pattern. If you will see, sound travels like this wave. How the wave, how you can say that it is a wave? I will explain you in this video why you will tell that it is travels in a wave motion. Okay, first we will go see through this. See, sound needs a medium. What is a medium? Medium, yesterday I have told you, it is any substance or any material which is needed for the propagation, as sound needs a medium. So what medium should be? The medium should be continuous. It should be a continuous medium to reach. Now air, everywhere air is present, so it acts as a continuous medium. Elastic. Elastic means molecules should move. Okay, so then only the vibrations can pass through each other. So it should be elastic or material medium, any material, it should be solid or liquid, all these types of material. So it needs any kind of material for the propagation. Now you are going to study what is wave. Now there is a calm pond nearby you, and you are sitting near that and you are throwing a stone into that pond. Okay, what you can see, if you will throw a stone, okay, this is the water, and what happens, you are throwing a stone into that pond. Okay, so what happens when the stone falls over here, you can see the waves are producing nearby that, you can see the waves are produced. Okay, water is shifting. Actually, water is not shifting. What is shifting? The energy is making, energy is moving. Okay, the water is not, you can just see that the waves are created. Are you seeing that when you throw the stone in that and water is going away? No, actually water is not going. When you are throwing a stone into the water, what happens? The waves are produced over there. Okay, so what happens? The waves are produced means the waves are producing like this. This way waves are producing. So when the waves are produced, what happens? It moves away from the point of generation. What is the point of generation? Where the stone falls. The part where the stone falls is the part of generation, means at that, from that part the waves has generated. So this is the source of production of wave, and from this what happened? The waves have generated and it is moving away. It means the waves are passing. So water is not moving away. What happens? Just the waves are passing or moving away. Okay, so what is a wave? It is a disturbance. Actually the water was still, but when you throw the stone in the water, means what? You have disturbed the water. Okay, so actually what is the wave? It is a disturbance created in the medium which propagates. Okay, it is a disturbance in the medium which propagates in all direction. You can see it is moving in all directions from the point of generation. A very simple definition. Okay, it is called a wave. It is a disturbance created in a medium which propagates in all directions from the point of generation. It is called as a wave. Okay, now what is the motion? Now here you can see the waves are generated, but it is moving. You can see they are in motion, means they are propagating in all direction, and such this propagation is called as wave motion. Okay, the propagation of wave is called as wave motion. So you have studied about the wave, you have studied about the wave motion, and so from this what you have understood, that sound propagates as a wave. As I have explained you here, how sound also same. Now if I am not talking for a while, if I am keeping quiet, will their molecules move? No, they will remain as it is, means they will remain undisturbed condition. Okay, when I will start talking, now I am start talking, means what? Here as I have told you that just place your hand over here, you can see the vibration, you can feel the vibration. I am talking means my sound which is coming from through my mouth is disturbing the air molecules nearby. Okay, when these air molecules are disturbing, they get vibrates. Okay, and they are passing my sound towards you. Okay, they are propagating like this, compression, then rarefaction, compression, rarefaction, and like this they are moving towards the ear. Okay, so similarly, why this called as wave motion again? Okay, here what? Same condition. Now you are, so here also same, what happens? I am disturbing the sound, I am disturbing the air molecules, that's why air molecules get vibrate and it propagates. Same, this concept and this concept is same, that's why it is called as sound propagates as a wave. Okay, till here I hope you all have understood till here. Still if you have any doubt related to wave motion, you can ask me. Okay, now I am going to explain how this compression rarefaction can be converted into a wave, why it is called as the sound is a wave motion. I will explain you. Now here I have explained you that this part is compressed part where air molecules come together. It is compressed part. Compressed part means at that point there is a high density of air molecule. High density means graph will go how? It will go like this. Okay, graph will go at high density like this. Again what happens here? Again it decreases and becomes low, low, low. Okay, again the graph will come, decrease means the graph will come down. Okay, actually I am drawing a graph of compression and rarefaction over here. Okay, this is a graph which is drawn for the compression and rarefaction, means high density particle and low density particle. For compression what happens? Air particles compress, means high density, density is high, so I will increase, density is increasing at such point. After that you can see lines have become fainter, fainter, fainter. So what happened here? Again it comes decrease, decrease. At rarefaction means this part. It is decreasing, so it will come out downwards. Again from here you can see again compression is there. Then again here you can see compression. Then again here rarefaction, then compression, then rarefaction. Like this the wave goes on. So if you will draw the graph of this part, compression means high, rarefaction means low part. Then again compression, again rarefaction. If you will draw this, you will get a wave pattern. Okay, so this, so that's why it is called so it is called as sound is a wave motion. Understood till here? Now we are going to see some different parts of this graph. Okay, now see here, this is as it is below means what it is? Rarefaction. And as it is upward means what it is? Compression. Okay, this was here, but now we are going to study some concept related to this. That is, first one is wavelength. Name itself suggests, wavelength means it is a length of a wave, or it can also be said as distance between consecutive crest and trough. Now what is crest and what is trough? Okay, now see here, very simple for your understanding, I will give you a shortcut. See, compression means crest and rarefaction means trough. Means what? In a graph, the compression part, that is this upper part, the wave, you can see it is divided. The whatever wave which comes above this line, they are called as crest, and the part which is drawn below the line, it is called as trough. Okay, actually means what? Compression means only we are drawing upward, means high you are showing. This is called as crest, and rarefaction means it is low density part, and it is below this line, it is called as trough. Just a simple part. Compression means only crest and rarefaction means only trough. Okay, when it is shown in the graph, that time we are called as crest and trough. Okay, crust is created by compressions, trough is drawn, it is drawn because of the rarefaction part. Okay, so this is the wave length. So what is the wavelength? It is a length of wave. Now just I want to show you one wave. How this one wave is considered? Here you can see one wave means this much part. This, if you will see this part, this is a one wave. Okay, some students will think that only this much is one wave, this is another wave. No, that is wrong. Okay, one wave means this. This much is the one wave. Here you can see from this part like this till here, this is one wave. I have drawn with the blue color. Here you can see from this point to this point is called the wavelength. If you want to measure the length of the wave, how, from where you will measure? From this point to this point, that is the wavelength. Okay, or also you can consider this also, you can count this way or this way also. If you have to draw from one, this part and this, in the wavelength you have to consider a crust, a trough and a crust also. Okay, here if you will see this one wave and this wave, here crust is also there, trough is also there. Okay, crust is also there, trough means consecutive crust and trough. Like this it should be, one crust and one trough should be there for a wavelength. Understood? So this is a wavelength. From here till here, it is a wavelength. It is denoted by a letter called lambda, L-A-M-B-D-A. This is the symbol of lambda. It is inverted Y. You can see, it is denoted by the letter lambda. Now here, next is amplitude. Now if you will see, amplitude means what? Simply I can say you, the height. Height of the wave. It is called as amplitude. If you will see here, this part means how much high it is, that is called as amplitude. Height of the this crest or height of trough, it is called as amplitude. Distance from midpoint to the trough, if you will say the midpoint from this midpoint to the trough or midpoint to the crest, it is called as amplitude. And then the part is called frequency. Okay, what is frequency? It is also a very simple concept. See here, I will show you frequency. It is the number of waves. It is a number of waves or number of vibrations that occur in unit time. Suppose here, see, I am drawing here. I have drawn like this. So what is the frequency of this type of graph which I have drawn? Means here, actually I am asking you, how many waves are there? How many numbers of waves are there? Now you can count here, from here till here, 1. from here till here 2, here till here 3, here till here 4, and here till here 5. Means how many waves are there here? 5 waves are there. So what will be the frequency of this type? Frequency, it is denoted by letter N, or suppose sometimes it is denoted as F also. So here I am taking N. N is the frequency. So how many waves are here in this type? 5 are there. So what will be the frequency? Frequency will be N equal to 5. This frequency part is very simple. You can find now here. See here, again another I will draw here. What is the frequency of this type of graph? This graph, you can see, count the waves, how many waves are there? 1 wave, 2 wave, 3 wave. So what will be the frequency of this part? N equal to 3. So here the frequency is N equal to 3. Number of vibration that occurs in unit time is called frequency. In a unit time, okay, here the time should be fixed. In a fixed time, once the wave, there are 3 waves, once there is 5 wave. So frequency of first graph which I have drawn, it was 5, and frequency of the second, it was 3. In a unit time, how many waves are produced, okay, or how many vibrations are produced? That is called as frequency. Just simple, just count. Now you all will tell me, okay, this is a question for you, that I want the frequency for this graph. Okay, don't consider this and this part. Just tell me the frequency for this graph. Okay, just message me or put in the WhatsApp group. Just send me what is the frequency of this one graph. Don't consider this and this. Just I want a frequency. Okay. So, time period now. Now, next is time period. Very simple. What is time period? The time taken to produce a one complete wave. To produce one wave, how many time is taken? How much time is taken? That is called as time period. Time period is denoted by letter T. Okay. So, this is the part related to the propagation of sound. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Okay, now here again we'll go wavelength. It is denoted by letter lambda. It is the length of the wave. Amplitude, what it is? It is the distance from the midpoint to the crest, or midpoint to the trough. Okay, it indicates the height of the wave. So the height of the crest or height of the trough, that is called as amplitude. It is denoted by letter A. Frequency of the wave, what is the frequency of the wave? It is how many number of waves produced in per unit time. That is called as frequency. Time period means time taken to complete or to produce one complete wave. It is called as time period, which is denoted by letter T. Thank you.